Hello and welcome to this special edition of Market Guru. As the big 2014 general elections near, leading market participants in India fear political instability as the biggest risk to the Indian equity markets. That's the key takeaway from the CFA Institute's Global Market Sentiment Survey 2014. Joining me to talk about the findings of this survey and his view on the markets is Navneet Munot, Chief Investment Officer at SBI Mutual Fund. Thanks very much, Navneet. Let's talk a bit about this rather interesting survey. 78% of the people polled in India were of the view that the biggest risk to the local markets in 2014 is political instability, and that's up from 60% last year. What is this political instability which is concerning everyone, and is that one of the reasons why these results and what's really going to happen in 2014 is weighing so heavily on our markets?
Yeah, I mean, it's substantially different than what the respondents in most of the other countries have expressed their views, where the weak global economic conditions is the biggest risk compared to the political instability. But in India, obviously, having seen last couple of years where it, particularly in terms of the impact on both the macro capital flows, currency and markets, the political situation had an overwhelming impact, whether people call it policy paralysis or the execution logjam, which particularly impacted the investment cycle. The political situation has been overwhelming in terms of the risk that people are seeing. We have seen the market's reaction to the state election results, and everybody is looking forward to the central election in 2014.
However, the survey also says that 43% of CFAs in India were of the view that there is a risk to the global economy, and that could be weighing heavily as well. And that perhaps explains why the tapering and the election, these are the two issues really at least for the next 6 months, which seem to be going to be driving the Indian markets. Is that correct reading of these numbers?
Yeah, I think from the global market perspective also, the view on the global economy is positive this year. Relative to what it was, I think, last year. Of course, we have seen better economic data from US, from Europe, and also from Japan. In fact, in terms of the expectations about the global economy, more people have shown an optimism this year. Having said that, at the same time, they are concerned about some of the matters, particularly in case the global economy shows a slowing momentum that could have an impact on the Indian market. And two or three things which can have bigger impact, when people were asked about the things that can impact local markets, it was any geopolitical risk in Middle East, because that can impact energy prices, and also the tapering of the quantitative easing, not only by US but central banks in general, was cited as another risk for the local markets as well.
In fact, it's interesting. I just want to pick up the thread on that last point that you made, because the survey says that 96% of those surveyed felt that effects on energy prices caused by an unrest in the Middle East would have a really negative impact, and 85% thought that the central bank's attempt, the point that you just made, to end quantitative easing would have a negative impact. Could you explain these two?
Yeah, so people were given questions on which are the events that can have negative impact on your market, and then these events were cited. So rise in energy prices due to geopolitical risk in Middle East, or the withdrawal of the quantitative easing by central banks. And obviously, most of the people responded that yes, almost I think 9 out of 10 people responded that yes, these events will have negative impact on our markets. The another point I would like to highlight, compared to last year, where a lot of people mentioned about the risk coming from the sovereign default risk, particularly from the Eurozone, I think to some extent that risk has come down. I mean, particularly people's perception about the risk from the global markets, to the extent people were more worried about the Eurozone situation, that has receded to some extent this year.
Interestingly, while the question that was asked on what do you think has contributed the most to the current lack of the finance industry, there one sees, while the issue of lack of ethical culture still remains, but the point is, it seems to have declined from last year. While 71% of the polled felt last year that there was a lack of ethical culture, which was the biggest risk. That's come down to 54%. Would you attribute that to stronger regulatory measures? How would you categorize that?
Yeah, obviously, I think it's not only the better enforcement, but also I think the awareness that this industry needs to work a lot more harder to regain the confidence of investors, to rebuild the investors' trust. In fact, in some other places and in some other questions, when people were asked the two regulatory reforms they want to see or two things that they would emphasize, in India it clearly came out that enforcement of the current laws and better corporate governance came right at the top. So I think people are looking forward to better enforcement of the current laws, and I think it seems that people are not looking at lots of new laws, but the better enforcement by the regulatory agencies and also the better corporate governance compared to some of the other markets in the world where it was more about the financial derivatives or the disclosure standards or some of the other matters. But in case of India, these two things came right at the top.
Also, very interestingly, Navneet, there was a question posed on, in the coming 12 months, do you anticipate a financial bubble in your local market? Now, 48% of those in India felt that there could be a real estate bubble in Asia. Does this include India as well? And what is your own view? Would you say that domestically, given the way our stock prices and the larger market has been moving up, it gives a sense that we are in a bit of a euphoric zone, according to you?
In fact, globally, when this question was posed, I mean, thousands of people have responded to this questionnaire from the 110,000 CFA charter holders across 110 countries. Relative to last year, the possibility of a financial bubble in next 12 months, I think the people who have responded from a positive perspective are much lower this year. I mean, people are not expecting a financial bubble as much as they were fearing last year. In case of India, I think most of the people, in case there is a bubble in any asset class, real estate came at right at the top, and you mentioned 58% number. In fact, some of the other Asian markets in China, Hong Kong, and some of the other developed markets like Canada and Australia, if I remember correctly, have given a similar feedback where people are more worried about, in case there is a bubble, that seems to be there in the real estate space and not as much in the financial space. So it looks like a lot of people keep saying that the global markets, both equity, junk bonds, are at a multi-year high in US, Europe, Japanese equities. But still, it seems that people are not worried about a repeat of something like a 2008. Whatever risk they are seeing from a financial market perspective, I think it's more from the real estate side than the other parts of the financial markets.
Let's also talk about the other very important finding that this survey throws up, and which is on the standards of financial reporting. That concern seems to have gone up from 31% to 34% as far as the local market is concerned. Clearly, there seems to be an enhanced sense of fear on the correctness or on the credibility of financial reporting by companies in India.
That is what I mentioned earlier also. I think when people were asked the regulatory reforms they want to see is the better enforcement of the current laws and regulation, and the corporate governance was the other matter. Obviously, people want better disclosure standards from the corporates and markets in general, and I think that's true of most of the other markets as well.
There also seems to be concerns on disclosures and use of derivatives by financial firms. That seemed to have come up as another big concern area. Is that a lot to do with the recent concerns even that the regulator has expressed in terms of forex hedging, for example, where a lot of it has not been disclosed by a lot of companies or by banks? Is that one of the big concerns among CFA members?
There is a concern about the global markets, and I'm not sure whether as much as related to the Indian markets. When people were asked what is the biggest risk they see from a global markets perspective, in that context they mentioned that the disclosure of related to the financial derivatives is something which is there in their minds, and also a systemic risk which can come anywhere in the world. That was the another risk that people highlighted.
Let me now talk to you in your capacity as someone who manages billions of dollars yourself along with your team. How are you seeing these markets moving? Do you see a sense that they have cooled off, of course, from those all-time highs we saw recently, but do you continue to see them moving in a more narrower band from here on, or do you see excessive volatility even going forward in the next few months?
So if I mean, taking the cue from this survey, if you look at the difference between the mentality of the investors here compared to rest of the world, weak economic conditions is the biggest concern for any investor anywhere in the world about their own markets. But in case of India, as we mentioned earlier, overwhelmingly, I mean, people think that political instability is a risk. People are not as concerned about the weak macro conditions, that the GDP is growing at 4.5%, the CPI is about 10%, or the IIP is still in a negative territory. People are not worried because it seems that people think these are cyclical issues which can be sorted out with a stronger government in place, with a better policy outcome. And I think that's why the whatever optimism we are seeing is stemming from that fact, that in case of India, the structural story is very much intact. What we are going through are more cyclical issues which can be handled in case we have a stronger government in 2014. And increasingly it seems that market is getting positioned for that.
How much of a risk, according to Navneet, is the fact that we continue to see heavy redemptions both from mutual funds and insurance investors, and therefore our dependence on FII flows seems to be much more perhaps than other markets? And perhaps this is a risk which many people don't necessarily talk about, because we are far more dependent on FII flows for the simple reason that our own domestic investor has been sitting out and in fact been redeeming very, very significantly. How much of a risk, according to you, is that?
No, absolutely. I think we need to deepen our capital markets. We need to regain the trust of our investors. One, the overall savings have come down, and also within the household savings, a larger proportion has gone to physical assets. We need to reverse that and then gain the investors' trust and confidence into the financial assets like equities and long bonds. And I'm sure that over the next couple of quarters, as we are already seeing that a lot of investors, I mean in this survey also, that people are seeing real estate as a potential bubble, and also the relative attractiveness of gold has faded. I mean, in dollar terms, the gold has been going down. I think with the regulatory restrictions as well, I think in next couple of quarters, I would expect that investors would return back to and will get their asset allocation in right and would get back to equities and then the long-term bonds, which are offering attractive investment opportunities. As you rightly mentioned, that we have been heavily dependent on global capital flows. In last 5 years, post the Lehman crisis, we've got over $80 billion from global investors. They don't seem to be as perturbed by the domestic macro and the political conditions as the investors sitting here seem to be getting worried about. But I'm sure that now the things have started looking up. I think I am clearly of the view that the macro and the corporate profitability are bottoming out. In next several quarters, we'll see improved macro conditions, better corporate profitability. The valuations are reasonable, and with improvement in the overall political outlook, I'm sure that domestic investors are going to return to our market.
Let's talk about India's macros a bit. While there's been positive surprise on the CAD, Navneet, the numbers that seem to be coming out on inflation seem to be only more negative than they were in the past. Is that a big area of concern? And how do you see the Reserve Bank of India now reacting to this, considering that its stated stand has been that it wants to curb inflation?
We expect a rate hike from the central bank mainly due to the persistence of high consumer inflation and also the worries about the elevated inflationary expectations. I'm sure that from the last policy, whatever we could read, they are worried about the persistently sticky high inflationary expectations among the people. But if you go deeper into the data, the entire inflation, the high inflation that we are seeing is coming from the food category, and within the food also, it's more driven by things like fruits and vegetables, meat products, dairy products. In fact, the cereal inflation that we saw some time back, particularly in food grains, oil seeds, sugar, I think that has started coming off because of the bumper harvest that we had, and it was from the global conditions as well. But in some of the commodities like fruits and vegetables, where logistics play a big role, I think there we've got a major problem. Of course, one can argue that how much a central bank can fight against inflation in fruits and vegetables, but I think RBI is more worried about the inflationary expectations. Now, let me say this. I think next year, by this time next year, looking at a situation where last couple of years the monetary conditions have been tight, now the fiscal situation is tight. I mean, the government seems to be working on the red line of 4.8%. They've reduced the fiscal deficit. Globally, commodity prices have been very soft. You look at across, I mean, whether it's in metals, whether you look at even agri commodities, whether you look at soft commodities, all commodities, most of the commodity prices are at a multi-year low. Now, with this background, if we have a decent harvest next year and the government can manage the, take appropriate actions, particularly to target things like fruits and vegetables and some of these dairy and meat products, I'm sure CPI can fall substantially by this time next year on a very high base of last 4 or 5 years. Your economy is growing much lower than the potential growth rate. Persistence of this inflation is something we shouldn't be acceptable to the policymakers. And I'm quite optimistic by this time next year, it will be substantially lower. Meanwhile, as I mentioned, given the high inflationary expectations, central bank has to keep the policy tight. And in next few months, I wouldn't be surprised if we see one or two rate hikes.
Let's talk about earnings, Navneet, a bit. In a recent note that you wrote to your investors in your mutual fund, you said that the earnings season was a respite to the overpowering nervousness that had prevailed at the beginning. You have talked about 9% for FY14, broader market earnings growth, and 18% for FY15. Are you being a bit overambitious, or do you believe that the worst is definitely over and that could actually be a strong trajectory for the markets going forward if earnings are going to recover the way you've talked of them?
So it's driven by two factors. One is that I expect a cyclical recovery from next year onwards. I am particularly driven by the revival in the investment cycle, a lot of steps that the government has taken, and also I think a lot of maintenance capex that should start from next few quarters. And a lot of capacities which are yet to come on stream in last 4 or 5 years due to the policy issues, due to the execution issues, a lot of capacities which haven't come on stream, various issues, I mean, for example, in the coal supply in case of power sector, as they get sorted out, the top line can increase much more than what we have seen in last few years. And there would be a margin expansion as well as the input costs come down. I mentioned about the global commodity prices. One can expect a similar thing in rentals, in the wage growth. We had a very hyper wage growth for last 4 or 5 years. I think should cool down going forward. And also at some point in time, interest rate cost is going to be lower. So I think there is potential for margin expansion. The third important element, which really played a big role in terms of the better corporate performance in last quarter, is a weaker rupee. So we all have been worried about the weakness in rupee, but the positive aspect of it is it's bringing the competitiveness back to lots of industries, and particularly the export-oriented industries or the industries which are dependent on the global economy. So whether it's IT or healthcare or engineering or lots of other businesses which can benefit from a weaker rupee, I think we are going to see those benefits coming fully to the several parts of corporate India. Of course, the weaker rupee also impact the balance sheet where there are forex loans which are unhedged. But I think by and large, weaker rupee is going to help the corporate India. So these are two or three factors which give us confidence that the corporate profitability from next year onwards could be higher than the overall nominal GDP growth.
My final question to you, you write also in the same note that I referred to that your portfolios are increasingly shifting the tilt from the defensives to cyclicals. Can you tell us which sectors are you and your fund managers looking at more increasingly as we go into 2014?
So if you expect a gradual recovery in the overall economy cycle, and we believe it's going to be more driven by the investment cycle than the continuation of consumption alone, that's one part which we are trying to play through more industrials, at least the quality industrial names where balance sheets are in a good shape, because I mean in case of industrials, lots of companies in the overall engineering, construction, capital goods space, you are worried about the balance sheet. But wherever the balance sheets are in a good shape, that's one area. Also, the companies that can benefit from a weaker rupee, I think that's another area that one is looking at as a theme. And also, as I mentioned, that in case of economic recovery, I think the whole mid and small cap space where the valuation gap has widened considerably in last couple of years. I think that this has been one of the highest gap that we have seen in valuation between the large cap and the mid and small cap. I think there are lots of quality companies that are available at reasonable valuation. So having a more, I would say, defensive bias, which we played till few months back, gradually the bias is towards shifting to more and more cyclical names, which can benefit from not only the better economic conditions, but also the better market conditions as people go down the market cap curve.
What about the entire banking space? Are you worried about that? Because concerns on NPAs still don't seem to have gone away.
You rightly mentioned, I mean, that has been a big concern. And so we have been, in terms of our portfolio positioning, we have been betting on the private sector names which are more into the retail lending space, because that has shown a lot of resilience over the last couple of years during this downturn. But the banks which are more heavy on the overall wholesale lending, they have seen a lot of stress in the portfolio, which is unlikely to go away in the very near future. So as and when you see better signs of cyclical recovery, you would like to play that, but by and large we have been more overweight on the private sector banks.
All right, Navneet Munot, thank you very much, like always, for coming by and sharing your thoughts. It's always a pleasure talking to you. Thanks for joining us here on Bloomberg TV India.